Hello, and welcome to 5-Minute Math. Today we are looking at the first grade concept of data, specifically how we can use bar graphs and picture graphs to create problems and solve them, and we'll do it in 5 minutes or less. So we have a simple bar graph here about what are some students' favorite food. We have three options here: pizza, ice cream, and candy. And before we move on to start writing our questions, let's make sure we write these numbers on the graph. It's always good to label our bar graph. This first bar, pizza, it's pretty easy because it's right next to the numbers on the left side. But these other bars are a little bit farther away, and candy is all the way over here on the far side. So always a good idea to label your bar graph with numbers so you're not always having to trace the line over to the left to find the number. So we've got pizza, we've got ice cream, and we've got candy. What kind of questions can we ask and then answer? So one of the questions that we'll probably need is how many students voted. And the way we can get that is we're going to take all of our numbers and we're just going to add them up. But a good question is always, how many are there in all? How many students voted? And we'll just put in all, because that's a good way to let us know we're having an addition problem. So we've got 10. And we've got 5, and we've got 7. So let's see. Let's put these two together. So we're going to put those two together. So 5 and 7 is going to make 12. So I'm going to say 10 plus 12. Now I know if I use my 100 chart, if I start at 12 and move down a row, it's going to equal 22. If I take 12 and add 10 more, my tens digit changes from a 1 to a 2. So we could say 22 students voted in all. Another good question is, how many more questions? Those are going to be subtraction questions. How many more? Think, which one do we want to do? Let's do candy. How many students, and we'll say, chose candy. Now candy's our first one, so that's going to have to be our larger number. So if we choose candy, and the only one we can compare it to is ice cream, because ice cream is less. The first one needs to be more. How many more students chose ice cream or candy than ice cream? So it's going to be 7, take away 5, and that's a basic fact. That's going to be 2. Let's see what we can do with a picture graph. Now we have a simple picture graph. We're counting apples, bananas, and grapes, just like we did before. Let's go ahead and label these so we don't have to keep counting. And so we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I count 6 apples. There's only 4 bananas, and then there are 3 clusters of grapes. So one thing that we can do is we can ask how many different fruits there are altogether, but we've already done that with the bar graph. Let's do another compare. But let's try this one. We're going to ask how many more, because that's what we're going to use for compare. But we're going to have the question be a little bit different. And we'll say these are students. And we're going to first add two of them. We're going to say bananas and grapes. So we're going to say, how many more students chose bananas and grapes? And when we put this and, that means we're going to need to combine both bananas and grapes. And then we'll say then the other one, apples. So look what we have to do here. This is what we call a two-step problem, or a multi-step problem. So first we need to figure out how many chose bananas and grapes. So that's going to be bananas is 4, grapes is 3. So if we add those two together, we're going to get 7. And then bananas and grapes, then apples. So now we can put our apples in here, and we can take that away, and we can say 7 minus 6 is 1. So it looks like our answer is 1. Let me show you how we can write all that into one big equation. It might look a little bit strange. So we can say 4 plus 3 minus 6. Look at that. We did a plus and a minus together. And that's going to make 1. What we did is we just grouped these two together. 4 plus 3, we made that 7. And 7 minus 6 equals 1.